Father in heaven, we thank you. Thank you, faithful, faithful, gracious, loving Father. Thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ. Thank you for your love for us. And thank you for being God. This morning again, we have come and we ask, Lord, your grace that has brought us into this week. Let the grace see us through this week. Let this week be a blessing for us. And let your name be glorified. Thank you, Father. Please send your word to us this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My beloved friends, this week we'll be taking through a series throughout every day of this week. We'll be doing a series on giving. Giving. And I pray that the Lord Himself will speak to you and I. I'm taking my text this morning from the book of Acts. This is a testimony of someone about what Jesus said about giving. Now, you know, testimony of someone means that the person is saying that person is not just saying, the person practices. So somebody is giving us a testimony of a statement of Jesus Christ, and the person is trying to confirm to us that Jesus Christ practiced what he said. And I'm believing God for you and I, that the message will be worthwhile. And Jesus, I should paraphrase it, Jesus says, it is more blessed to give than to receive. That is the word of Jesus Christ our Savior. He said it is more blessed to give than to receive. And I'm believing God that that statement will come to you. If somebody is recounting what Jesus said, it means that it's of great importance. More blessed to give than to receive. In Genesis chapter 18, if you read from verse 1 to 12, a man practiced what Jesus said and things changed for him. Abraham had been believing God for fulfillment of a promise for 25 years. The promise of Isaac. And one day he saw three men on a journey and he perceived. You see, one thing about giver is that givers have this push that pull them to do the right thing. When you are a giver, circumstances will not hinder you from giving. You are not giving because you have plenty, you are giving because you are a giver. So Abraham, it's not because he has plenty alone, but because he has the principle of giving. He saw the three men and he felt these are travelers. Let me minister to them. The Bible says in Hebrew 13, he said, we should not miss the opportunity of entertaining strangers because we might be entertaining angels. And on that occasion, he did entertain angels. And those angels said in verse 10 of 18, Genesis 18 verse 10, they said to him, they said to the wife, is there anything difficult for God to do? Sometimes your giving opens you to fulfillment of promises. Sometimes your giving connects you to your destiny helpers. In this case of Abraham, it connected him to fulfillment of promise. And that is why in chapter 22 of the same Genesis, if you read from verse 1 and 2, the Bible says, God called Abraham, come and give to me that which you prefer most, that which you, your precious gift. And he was willing to give. He said, giving is if you have the grace to give, it's incurable. It's not about that whether you have or you don't have. It is that you see a need and you see an opportunity to catch on. And he went ahead and he gave God the Isaac that God asked for, his most precious possession. And in verse 15, the Bible says, God said, for you have done this thing, in blessing I will bless you. I pray for somebody listening to me that giving that you must give, that will change your story, that will bring fulfillment of your destiny. May the enemy not hinder you from giving it. May you find grace to give it.
Amen.
I want you to think about it, and I'll see you tomorrow. The Lord bless you, and the grace to release your Isaac so that you can receive grace, generational blessing.